Kerwin's Game Store, the best place in gaming.
Kevin is running FAT, as he calls it. Fire Fist, Artifact, Trap Tricks. And Nick is running Mermails, as he often tends to do. Good Mermail player. Great. Great Mermail player, actually. He's been playing them for a long time. Still sticking with them to this day. In this format, where they're actually not... They haven't been doing too well after that first top they had. People were really hyping the Power of Soul Charge in the deck. Nick is, of course, running two. Still just a staple. Yeah, so... Mermails. Nick's running, you know, your general Mermail deck. Running three of most of the Mermail monsters. You got the... He's got two Megalos. Other than that, he's got three TS, two Turge, three Pike, Lind, three... He's running main deck to emptiness. He's also running three Reckless Greeds. He's running a Gores in the main deck, but aside from that, you know, nothing too crazy. You got your Soul Charges. Kevin is running FAT. He's running three Fire Fist Bears along with the Artifact Trap Tricks engine. Kevin will go first. He starts out with the Duality, revealing Pav Duality, Trap Tricks, Trap Hole Nightmare, Deep Risen, and he grabs the Nightmare. Shuffles and cuts. He's got a bear in his hand, a nightmare, a lance, and a mystery trap card. He's set three. I assume he's summoned. I guess he doesn't want to summon bear into what could be bad here. Possibly he does. Nick's going to start off by spacing. He hits the nightmare. Proceeds to summon Lind, which attacks into a Deep Risen. Kevin takes his turn, summons Bear, attacks Nick's life points. Nick takes 16, putting him down to 64. Search out a Tenki from his deck, which will grab something that's under the glare. I don't know if they can do anything about that glare. I'll see after the match. Here's just to be another bear. Sets two more back rows and ends his turn. Both players know what they're playing against at this point, most certainly. Reveals a TS from his hand, discarding Marksman. He knows that the Nightmare is gone. He's going to hit the Bottomless, which is going to be chained to the TS. TS is going to get his effect. Definitely not the optimal card to have hit here. But he has no information as to what those back rows are. It looks like Kevin's sitting on Wolfbark and Bear in hand. Nick's still looking through his deck. Search out a Pike. He needs more searches if his hand isn't very well established, or he could just search out Lind, but he knows that Kevin has another bear, which would deal with Lind pretty handily. He is going to search for Pike. See if he has anything to follow it up with. He normal summons Pike, discarding Tias. That's an interesting play. He already used Tias this turn, got a search off of it. He could, I mean, this is... He's got two cards in hand. So he's at... He's gonna add the gun to his hand, so he's got four to Kevin's six right now. If you don't count the tanky, that's five. I mean, he's not that far behind in advantage. He's done reasonably well to keep the advantage. To not let second going second hurt him that much. Alright, so he's going to summon Aqua Spirit and make an Exciting Knight. That's a strong play here. It's going to resolve fully. It's going to hit a Moral Talk, though, which is going to allow Moral Talk to get summoned and pop the Exciting Knight. So, alright, Nick's got two cards in his hand. And we're right back at it. I mean, Kevin's up one card in advantage. still an okay exchange for Nick. Get something out of the way, but he does know about the bear, which is gonna most certainly cause problems down the line. Soul charge for Nick here. She's gonna go down to 44 total. Targeting 2, getting back Aqua Spear and Pike. So allow him to make a rank. It's gonna be hard to get over the Trite. Depending. He could make a Black Ship. Then that's not gonna deal with the Shark. Don't know if Nick runs 2 Trites here, and he does. So Shark sticking around actually matters, if this is the play. Seems we're having trouble with the stream here. Just need to make sure that. Seeing data, yes. I mean, it looks like it says it's broadcasting. That's not good. Yeah, we're not right in the middle of the fucking match. Alright, stream is back. It would appear that Kevin did make Black Ship against the Shark. Somehow he was able to get rid of the Shark. We missed all of that due to the stream going down. I don't know what it was from, but in the process, Nick has gone down to 3,800 life points. Just gonna get everything caught up here. Yeah. Alright. So, we're on Nick's turn. Nick's got a Megalo out. He's got 2 in hand. Kevin's got Moral Talk and a Black Ship with 1 set. Nick then proceeds to summon an Abyss Osha, targeting his Megalo. Allow him to special summon a level 4 and a level 3. Oh, he targeted Abyss Osha. I didn't see that. Alright. Megalo's going to get deprisoned. He's going to swing his Lind into... I'd assume the moral talk here. Which will allow him to summon out... I don't know if he's used his gun yet since the stream went down after that. If he has his gun, he could summon Turge, get Pike, make rank 4. Nick was another 600 from this attack of Lin, but he's still deciding on what he wants to summon here. He's gonna summon a Megalo. He only runs 2 Megalos, so this means that he's out of Megalos in the deck. He won't be able to draw them, which is quite good considering he only has 1 card in hand. The Megalo would just be a drawback at that point. He's gonna swing over the Moral Talk, doing 300 to Kevin, putting Kevin at 77. Pass the turn to Kevin. Kevin puts Black Ship in defense position and sets a trap. Ends his turn. Turn passes to Nick. Nick attacks with the Megalo. Ends his turn after setting a back row. Kevin sets a back row, goes back to Nick. Actually, Kevin's looking at his extra deck here. Yeah, Nick's looking at Kevin's graveyard. So Kevin summons a bear. All right, so 16 was being swung at Kevin. He activates his Sanctum. After he took the 15 from the Lind, putting him down to 62. Central was chained. Nick's gonna summon Wind, he runs it into Moral Talk again. Takes another 600, puts him down to 26. We'll release Turge and Pike. Let's see what he makes here. Makes an arc. Arc's gonna take the Moral Talk. And ends his turn. A duality for Darkhold, Bear, and Upstart. Kevin is laughing. He does not seem to like the results here. He's gonna grab the Upstart. I'd say that's the best play. This way he doesn't reveal what he has. He could possibly top deck a trap card. Still has AD Prism left in his deck. That'll be an okay draw here. Activate the Upstart that puts Nick to 36. Let's see what he drew, but it looks as though he set it. He's got Trap Tricks Mermelio. Summons her. Still allow him to search out. A nightmare, I believe. He has a failed search. And passes the turn back to Nick. Nick draws. Definitely worked his way out of this position pretty well. Kevin had a strong opening. He's gonna attack. Over, which means that puts Kevin down to 2. Oh, and that's the game, okay. Yeah, sorry about that. Everything got messed up with the stream going down, so a lot of the game is going to be out of sequence for game 1, sadly. Thankfully, in game 2, we'll be able to salvage that as both players go to their side decks, with Nick taking game 1 here. It's hard to say where this matchup goes, considering it's basically a Fire Fist deck versus a Mermail deck, except Fire Fists only have one Wolf Mark now, so their late game is not nearly as good as it used to be. At the same time, Mermails kind of have an issue where if they use their resources too quick in the early game, it's hard to gain advantage back after expending those resources. Is up one game, going into their side decks. Let's see what everyone has. Alright, so first we'll start off with Kevin, since he's going to be the one going first. He's got Majesty's Fiend in his side deck, one copy, 2 debunks. Those are good against Mermails. Majesty's is good too. Can resolve them very good. He's got Deep Dark Trapple times 2, Acid Trapple times 1, 2 Full Houses, 2 Mystical Space Typhoons, 3 Noblemen of Crossout, 1 D-Fisher, and 1 Granmole. D-Fisher, Debunk, Majesty's Fiend, all really good here. I imagine he's looking at those. Nick, on the other hand, he has Effect Valor times 2, DD Crow times 2, Fossil Dino times 2, Breakthrough Skill times 2, 1 Catastrophe times 2, Flame Imprisoning Mirror times 2, 2 Needle Ceilings, and 1 Space. I imagine we'll probably see Malevolent Catastrophe here. Valor is okay. Breakthrough's very good, knowing that Kevin runs Moral Talk. We'll probably be setting that in. And Kevin will be going first in game 2, as you should, you know, most people know you should always go first if you have the option to. Both players exchanging pleasantries. Imagine talking about the last game. A good laugh here and there. That's always nice to see. Always nice to see friendly competition. Extends the handshake, and we're off to game 2. Alright, so Kevin starts off with a tanky, strong reveal as it plays it. Always a good opening play. Grabs Bear to his hand. Adds it. He's got Wolf Bark again in his hand, it would seem. That's always good. Deck's gonna get cut. Reveals off the top Lance, Bagel Talk, and Debunk. There's the Debunk. He's gonna get Beagle Talk. Alright. Or Beagle Talk, or however it's pronounced. Not quite sure on that one. He's gonna summon the bear. Shuffle some back rows. I believe one is a lance. Don't know about trap cards that he had. He's gonna pass back with Wolf Park and one was the Beagle Talk. Alright, so we've got a Beagle Talk set, a lance, and a mystery card. Nick sets a monster in a back row and passes. There's the Nobleman. Alright, so Nobleman, I was going to say, is a good card if you're going second, because it is good against a set Lin, but looks like he decided it going in first too, and it's getting him ahead right here as he's going to swing with one of his bears into a sphere. Don't think he has an MST respond to this too. He's thinking though on the activation of sphere. Alright, so Nick's going to summon out Lin from his deck. Bear's going to attack it. Alright, so in this position, Nick can either just summon a big monster, but it'll just add a bear, but he could summon a combo monster in the form of Pike or Turge. But the issue is that he knows that there's a Beagle Talk set, so if he's got a marksman in hand, it'll just let the Beagle Talk summon itself, possibly causing a combo, but it won't be able to destroy anything. He's going to summon Pike. Let's see if he has a piece to go with it. He has a title. This will allow him to get a free search. I mean, title is a free card, but a good attack here from Kevin. He has nothing to really worry about here. He's just going to swing over that pike anyway. Neither of his bears are going to get their effect, though, but he's pretty far on the board right here. Neither players are taking any damage here. No upstarts have been played. Nick's going to really think about this. He's going to grab marksman. Alright, so he's looking to get plays going. It's a nice start. Oh, Kevin's going to pop it. Oh, because he got the... Did he replay off of? That's interesting. So he's going to exceed someone for rank 4. Which I think might be Rhapsody and Berserk. It's an Abyss Dweller, okay. There's like a purple glare on it. So he makes an Abyss Dweller. He passes back to Nick. Nick's sitting on 5 in hand. Yep, 5. He's got 3 monsters. Trap card. That went too quickly into spell card. He's got a DD Crow, a Soul Charge. Cannot see it. Is that... I believe it's a Megalo. It's a lead. I don't believe he runs lead, though. Yeah, he does not run lead. Without Mermail Mirror Matches, lead is not that important. This is interesting. So he's got a Soul Charge and a DD Crow. Soul Charge, you know, always pretty good. Yeah, it's a Megalo Art. Always pretty good for coming back in the game, but we'll see what he's got going for it. He's gonna activate the effect of Dweller in response to Megalo's reveal, which means that card effects in the graveyard cannot be activated. Therefore, when Marksman tries to activate on a separate chain, it's unable to. Nothing in the back row will be destroyed. Now, Kevin's got his Lance to protect that, which he will do when Megalo goes swinging at the Abyss Dweller, putting Megalo down to 17. Don't they tie? I believe they're supposed to tie here. Oh, Dweller's 18. Wow, yeah, okay. During the end phase, he ignitions the Beagle Talk. This will allow him to set the Moral Talk, which he is then going to, I assume, blow up with the Beagle Talk. Oh no. No, he just destroys it, sets. Oh, the DD Crow went on the Moral Talk. Okay, I didn't see that. I was doing the life tools. Okay, so yeah, now there's a Moral Talk set. Romelio summon, grabs a bottomless, shuffling the deck. He's gonna swing with Dweller. That's what I believe happened. Yep. So he swung in with Dweller and with the Trap Tricks Romelio for a total of 3,300 damage, putting him down to 4,600. Nick draws, he's thinking, not a good position to be in. He knows there's a bottomless set, he knows Moral Talk set, which doesn't do a lot. But the bottomless and the Dweller are problematic for him right now. He's gonna summon Megalo off of Sphere, which is gonna get bottomless. Does with that, deals with it handily. Dweller was activated during his standby phase to prevent Tidal from coming back. Nick has to normal summon or activate his Soul Charge here, because knowing that Kevin has Wolf Bark in hand, he does have a clock on Nick for next turn. He would be able to kill him. Let's see what he goes for here. He goes for too many. Look at Kevin's deck list. Kevin... I don't think he runs. Yeah, he does not run Heartland Draco, so doesn't have to worry about that. He goes too far in here. He's gonna go for 3. Putting him down to 1600. Oh yeah, he can't activate the Soul Charge because of the battle that he had before. Alright, so He wasn't able to activate his soul charge, which means that Kevin is going to take game two. We'll see if they want to change their side decks up. I think that Nobleman definitely came in pretty well for Kevin there. Had he not had the Nobleman, he would have had to swing into the Lind instead of... So he wouldn't have gotten the Sphere baited out, which would have given Nick more resources to work with. Both players looking at their side decks again. We'll go to Nick now, see what he's looking at. He's got the DD Crows in to deal with the artifacts. He's probably got Breakthrough Skill in there too. Maybe Malevolent Catastrophe. It's okay when you go second. And when you go first, it allows you to set it. And then your opponent hopefully won't blind it, space it, or anything. And they're going to establish their board. And next turn, you're able to blow up their field. Hopefully, but I don't know how I feel about it. Maybe he just keeps in the Breakthroughs and the DD Crows. Nick's going first here. Draws his opening hand. But, yep, there's a Breakthrough Skill. What else does he have? He's going to set a card, set two cards. Possibly set three cards? Nope, he's just going to pass with that. Two cards set. There's a Debunk in Kevin's hand, a Tanky. I believe a Sanctum I saw. For his deck, Red Bear. He's going to summon Bear. He's going to swing with Bear. The Bear's attack is good for 1700, which will put Nick down to 6300. Activate the effect of Bear, set a Tanky. Deck is cut. Can't activate that Hanky, obviously, this turn. Sets a bunch of back rows. This is how you want to start off, if you're Kevin here. End phase, Nick will Reckless, I believe. Yeah. I think he might be doing it as draw phase. I think that's what they're clarifying. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I believe this is his draw phase. Yep, it is. Kevin's going to chain the wiretap, putting that Reckless back in the deck. Pretty handily. That was a pretty good app there. He doesn't want Nick getting ahead. He doesn't want him having combo pieces. Even if it's going to cut him off from his draws, it's going to allow Nick to play the game. There's another Reckless. This one is going to go through. Had Nick activated those during the end phase, he could have had a very, very powerful play this turn. He drew another Reckless, it would seem. I think that's another Reckless next to the Breakthrough Skill. He's got an MST in his hand. A TS. He's going to reveal TS, discarding Infantry. That's strong. Trap Tricks, Trap will Nightmare will activate, destroying the TS. That's good. Cut off the search. See if Nick has a way to get out of this. Now that he can't search his deck, he's under Reckless. Thinking. What is he working with there? He's gonna set a card, set three cards, and end his turn. I assume he has the Reckless here, because if not, it's a very bad position to be in. He's gonna let the Tanky resolve. He does have an MST, so possibly has an answer to Bear, or he thinks that at this point Kevin is quite far ahead and he has to save his MST for pushing his plays through. Bear, yep. Bear's gonna swing into a Sphere. Alright, that's good. Sphere resolves successfully. He's gonna summon a Lind from the deck. In defense position. I believe we have a debunk from, yep, there we go, debunk from Kevin. Oh, he showed the debunk too early. Nick could possibly MST it because of the reveal of it in response to the redeclaration of Bear's attack. We'll see if he decides to do that. He's going to activate Malevolent Catastrophe in response. Alright. So Lin's going to die off of the Sphere. So is the MST. Which I don't think he had the MST set. So he didn't have Reckless. He had the Malevolent Catastrophe set. So we'll see where this goes. He's not taking any damage here. Because he can summon anything bigger than bear at this point. All the monsters that he summons are going to be bigger. Unless he summons Pike. But he could just summon Courage if he's going to go for a combo. He's probably just thinking about Megalo here. Kevin's got two Moral Talks and a Nobleman of Crossout in hand. That is not good. Means he drew Moral Talk for his turn. If he had had Moral Talk set, then the Malevolent Catastrophe wouldn't have hurt as much. He would have been able to summon it off of it. At least putting it on the board. Pike's going to summon. Pike's going to discard. Hild. He's going to search. Bear can still crash here. The amount of monsters on the field changed, so he does get a replay. He can also, swing at Osha's not going to do anything. He will just end his turn. I wonder if he knew about the replay. I feel like I would have crashed with the Pike there. Just because he's leaving himself open for a rank 3 play now, but then again, maybe that's what he wants. Because he has a Moral Talk set. Alright, so she's going to target herself. She's just going to go straight for the wind. Problem here for Kevin is I feel like he might have wanted to side out that Nobleman that he has set. He might have wanted to side out since he revealed it in game one. Now Nick has no pressure to set any monsters. It's ending up being dead here. There's a crash from the Pike. Wind's going to come in for 15, which puts Kevin down to 65. He's going to draw for his turn. It's a duality. Reels off the top. An MST, a Mermelio, and a warning. I'm guessing he wants Mermelio here. He still has Bottomless in his deck. I believe he only runs the one Nightmare. Yeah, he only runs the one Nightmare, so he still has Bottomless in his deck. He needs to get a monster going. He could perhaps grab the MST and use it to destroy his own Moral Talk. I didn't see what he drew for turn, though. Oh, it was the duality, obviously. Okay, so he's got MST set, Moral Talk in hand. Nick's gonna give up his final turn of Reckless. I believe he swung here, maybe? Kevin didn't reach for his calculator, though. Yeah, swings. Kevin goes down to 5k. Kevin's gonna set a final card here. Alright, in response to the attack, he's activating MST. Uh-oh. Oh, he's MST. Okay. Alright, in response, he's MSTing. In response to Kevin's targeting, he's going to destroy the Nobleman. Orthok's going to kill Wind. Let's see what Nick grabs here. He can grab Megalo and just swing over the Moral Talk, which is problematic. See what Nick's gonna go for. He has a lot of options. The Moral Talk is not a problem for him. He could just summon Megalo, beat over it, and yeah, see, he has a big beater on the field here now. So he bottomlesses because he destroyed the Lind with his Moral Talk effect. Lind's effect didn't activate during the damage step. This allows him to use the Bottomless, get rid of the Megalo. Clears the way for a 2100 attack, putting Nick down to 42. He sets one and passes the turn back to Nick. That was a good line of play from Kevin. Able to get rid of the Lind and get rid of the Megalo. Because of that Reckless, Nick is so far down in cards that even though Kevin's been making these 2-for-1 exchanges, it's actually turning out quite okay for him. He's able to make them just due to the fact of the Reckless not resolving with the second one like he had wanted to. Looks like you drew a soul charge for the turn, though. It's very strong if it is. Soul charge would be good for him right now. He doesn't have Megalo in the graveyard, though. I know he has a Tius. I believe that's his only level 7, though. He is going to soul charge. Let's see what he pays. 1, 2, just 2. Pike and Lin, putting him down to 22. It's a great card to have when you're down on advantage and down on the board. He's gonna summon another Pike out of his hand. It's probably gonna be for a Bahamut Shark. Exciting Knight. Interesting. One card ahead. He is allowed to use the Exciting Knight. This is gonna summon off of the Lin's gonna summon. Moral Talk's gonna summon on a separate chain as well. Nick is chain link 1. And Kevin at chain link 2. Kevin should summon first, I believe. It's gonna summon a Megalo. Moral Talk's gonna summon, destroy the Megalo. There are 3 minutes left in the round, roughly, I'm getting word of here. Roughly 3 minutes. Close game here. A good game. Yep, he's gonna enter battle phase, die to the Exciting Knight, just because he drew for turn. Put him a card ahead of Nick. Nick's gonna check Kevin's graveyard here. Kevin doesn't look too happy. He's at 5,000. Exciting Knight's gonna hit for 19. Puts him down to 31. He's gonna end phase destroy that with his ignition. This allows him to set either Moral Talk or Beagle Talk from his deck. Beagle Talk. Which one will he choose, though, is the question. I imagine he's thinking here what he can draw to use with whatever he sets, and he's probably going to choose Moral Talk because... Is he going to choose Beagle Talk? Alright. He chooses Beagle Talk. Neither of them is a good draw here, so... Just playing the odds. What does he draw for turn? Draws one sets. Passes back to Nick. Nick attacks for 19 again. Ignite. He's going to swing, kill the bear. Kevin draws for turn. Sets one. Reckless is activated for Nick. He's just got to get this damage in now. Just wants to force an attack through. The attack. Ah, there's the Sanctum. See, that's why I didn't set the... Did he draw more? Oh, gets another Beagle Talk. Alright. If he had set Moral Talk, that Sanctum could have allowed him to combo here, but... This game still is not over with that those two level 5s from Kevin. Exciting Knight obviously not able to beat over the defense of Beagle Talk. I believe he's either 2,200 or 2,100. More than enough to deal with the Exciting Knight. Time has been called in the round. I don't know if these players have a time extension, though, due to them being on screen. TS is going to be revealed for Nick, discarding Gund. Very strong. This is during main phase 2, though. He's gonna add Lin to his hand. Lots of players watching this match. Megalo is summoned off of the Gund. This will allow Nick to make rank 7. Whichever one he so chooses, that being Draco. Lots of Dracos on the screen today. Pop one of the Beagle Talks. Set one card, set a monster, and end his turn. Kevin just verifying that Megalo was not the scent monster. It would appear that they are in time. Nick's ahead on life points, though. I'm sure he feels pretty okay with the situation here. Lance going to be activated when the effect of Draco activates. And that is the game. Nick revealing title from his hand to show Kevin that he has nothing to fear with no backers gone. So Nick Golnick takes this match 2-1.